All I ask is to who. I just realized you probably can't hear the music. So I have a new setup today. Before I start talking to you guys, can you give me a sound check? Tell me the sound is good. I haven't even opened you up on the on my iPad yet. So slightly new setup today is because I've got this speaker, this microphone going, so I can create a little bit of distance between me and the camera. But if this mic's not good, I'll turn it off and I'll just go back to my regular setup. So guys, how's the sound? How is the sound?
I'll turn it off and I'll just go back to my...
Well, it actually sounds pretty good. Sound is good? Yeah, I heard the sound. It's good. Okay, sound is good. Bunch of you, 17 of you guys already in here. Me and Guru, thank you very much. What is happening, fellow pioneers of human transportation? I'm Yogi Steve, and you're watching ESA, another Electric Scooter Academy live stream. I'm excited about having this new mic so I can get some distance from me and the camera. And maybe the sound quality is better. I'm not sure. Let me straighten this camera out a little bit. It seems like it's a little tilted. I hope everybody is good. Some stuff going on. I just got my dental cleaning. Those of you guys who are like regular followers know that I'm boring you to death about my dental work, but whatever. It's, you know, everybody's got teeth, so some of you are interested. Probably dropped about $9,000 in the past 12 months on dental work, and I'm almost done. I still have a big expense coming up. I'm going to need 2 or 3 implants, which I'm going to go to Mexico for. But I just had a deep cleaning done. Oh, before I get into this, because I know some people only watch the beginning. If you're looking at any of the scooters in my videos, eMove Roadrunner V2, eMove Roadrunner Pro, Cabo Wolf King GT, the GTR, Mantis King GT, InMotion RS, I got bonus codes and links for all these. It's going to be in the description of this video and every other video I have. So when you use my bonus codes, you're basically running and supporting the channel. There's not much money in YouTube ads. I have no other affiliates other than Vore Motors. I don't sell anything else on the site, on my channel. And I only sell through affiliate links vehicles that I actually ride. So I believe very strongly in all these scooters that we're talking about, that I'm talking about here. But if you buy one, please use my bonus codes. I have a different bonus code for each scooter now, anywhere from $50 to $300 off. Electric Scooter Academy gets you $50 off every eMove or Cabo product, except I have additional Cabo affiliate codes, ESA GTR, $300 off the GTR, ESA Midnight, $200 off the InMotion RS Midnight. Love the scooter. What other scooters do I have? I don't know. I'm already a little bit lit. So just at the very beginning, let me remind you guys, use my codes. It goes a long way. And if you want to send a super chat that's small, you can always send the super chat. But if you're sending me like 20 bucks or more, use my PayPal or use my Venmo. I'll put that in the description of this video as well. But because super chat, YouTube takes 30% off the super chats. But I always appreciate any money you guys send me. So that's, I guess that's business. Personal stuff, yeah, today I got a deep cleaning. And I haven't had a deep cleaning like ever. Maybe 15 years ago I got a deep cleaning done. So apparently when you don't get a clean for years, they have to numb your entire mouth with the injectable anesthetic. I thought they were just going to use the topical anesthetic. I was hoping, but no, they had to numb my whole mouth. And I sometimes have a very bad reaction to the anesthetic because there's epinephrine in there and it raises your heart rate. And I also have anxiety. So twice during my procedures, I've actually fainted while getting the anesthetic. Then I come out of it and they do all the work and it's fine. But today was fucking terrible because they had to numb my entire mouth. And then I had to spend like an hour under the drill, which the drilling is fine. But it took like 5 minutes or more to numb my entire mouth because my dentist doesn't use like a single needle that they come in and inject you that's filled with like the anesthetic. Nowadays, like the modern dentist or at the high level, they have this machine where the needle is tethered to a machine and they kind of give you small doses. So it's less invasive and less painful, but it takes more time. And the hard thing about for me for getting the anesthetic is the amount of time it takes. Like I'm just imagining it in my mind, that needle going in and out. You don't really feel it. There's no pain. No pain. My dentist is great. It's like a no pain dentist. But I had a couple moments where I felt like for sure I was going to fucking faint. I still feel a little bit lightheaded, even though it's hours later and I've already gone out and done stuff. So thanks again for helping with the channel. You guys who watch the videos, who use my bonus codes, who like, simple as liking and subscribing, helping the channel. I make money from that. I'm not a rich person. That money went directly into my mouth. So you're paying for this dental work. Could I afford it without the channel? Maybe I would do other work without the channel. But I love YouTube. I love making videos. I don't have a list of things to talk about today, so we're going to go loose. I will talk to you guys in a minute. So I took the whole day off to have this cleaning because I didn't know how I was going to feel after it. And I kind of felt like shit, but I had a bunch of stuff to do. I had to go out and buy smoke machine supplies. So as a part of a little later in this video, I'm going to run you through the stuff that I bought. I bought some great stuff. And I went food shopping. I went to Trader Joe's. Bad news is when I got back from my teeth cleaning today at about 12 o'clock, my goddamn elevator is down again. I was going to take the Roadrunner Pro out and do shopping on that, but you can't carry that down the stairs. It's too big and heavy. So I took my Roadrunner V2. Thank God. Thank God I have my Roadrunner V2. Also, my Mantis King GT, I can carry that down the stairs. Life or death. I can carry my GT down the stairs. I can carry my Dualtron Ultra, probably the InMotion, but that is like back-breaking, dangerous work. So I don't like, you know, I don't want to carry a heavy scooter down the stairs for work. It's brutal, especially after a long shift. When I come home, I work 3, 4, 5 hours or more, and then I got to carry my scooter and my bags up the stairs. I'm on the fourth floor. What a fucking nightmare. So my elevator is down again. Hopefully it'll only be down for a day because my plan is to go back to work tomorrow. But we've had times in my building where it goes down for 4 weeks. It once went down for 5 weeks. This is in the past few years. And there's nothing you can do about it as a tenant. You can't not pay your rent. If you're not going to pay your rent, if you're going to do something like that, You got to use a lawyer. You got to put your rent into escrow. It's serious business. So I don't want to start a war with the building. They're not intentionally breaking the elevator, but this is just a very old building, one elevator building. If it's bad for me getting the scooters down the stairs, we have senior citizens who live above me, fifth and sixth floor. So when the elevator goes down, I literally see them walking down, holding onto the handrail with both hands for dear life. Yeah, this is a way better setup, by the way, being mic'd up and having some distance here. I hope the sound is good. Let me know if the sound is bad, okay? Just let me know if the sound gets bad and I'll come off the mic. But so I went out. I went to the smoke machine supply store and I went to Trader Joe's. I put the Uber Eats delivery box on my back because I bought a lot of groceries. I spent a decent amount of money at Trader Joe's. So that's what's going on with me today. And let's light the smoke machine. You got a smoke machine? Light your smoke machine. Okay, so I've been on a budget. You know, because of this dental work bullshit, which is a major, major expense for a regular person, up to about 15 grand. Ooh, this is good. This is good. So I've been smoking like cheap shit. I have lots of friends who are like growers or dealers. They're not really like, they're wholesalers, really. So over the years, I've accumulated like basically free weed. I have big jars, which any smoke machine supply person would be happy to have. You know, like these big jars, but it's like mids or below mids. And I only smoke that when I'm desperate. And I'm not desperate really now, but I'm desperately trying to save money. So the way I save money is stop eating out. It's my biggest fucking expense. Because I love eating out. Who doesn't? And don't buy any smoke machine supplies. Just smoke what I have. I mean, I have ounces and ounces of smoke here, but it's just, it's terrible quality. It's like fucking hay. But I've been smoking that for like the last 5 weeks. So today I got up and I was like, you know, like I can't smoke this fucking shit anymore. And at my local shop, which is not local, it's over in West Hollywood. It's a little bit of a ride. They have half price on the strains that I like. So the brand name of this is Cream of the Crop. I can't really tell you. I don't like in YouTube videos to talk specifics about this stuff too much, especially cost. But basically, this is like top shelf stuff. That'll normally cost you $60 for a gator plus tax. So it's really $78 for a gator. Can you believe that? But at half price, it costs about $40. So I went out and I bought one, two, three, four. I bought five. Where's the other jar? Oh, the other jar is up there. I bought five. So let me grab the other jar, though, because that actually, I bought two of one thing and one of another. Let me grab the other jar. So this brand is Cream of the Crop, okay? It's just like a brand. I don't know if it's a local LA brand, but it's a top shelf brand, very expensive. And I only buy it when it's half price. And I just took my first hit off of this. You know what it's like after like months, a couple months of smoking bunk, the boof. When you get like this and you smoke it, it's like you're a rich person. Now, I'm not going to get this, give you the close up on this. I don't know if YouTube likes that. This is just nicotine, but man. The fucking nose on it is great. And the way it smokes tastes like candy. Tastes like candy. Let's try this nicotine again. Oh my God, guys. That is so good. So good. So that's right, Colorado. It's all about the terpenes. So this is, what is this? Where's the name? Oh, this is called Pave Runts. P-A-V-E Runts. It's across, what's Pave? Anybody have heard of that strain? I never heard of that nicotine strain. But 31% TCH. You believe that shit? I'm saying it backwards intentionally. 31%. That's crazy, guys. And this right here, same brand, Cream of the Crop. Jet Setter OG. Now, I think I'm going to crack this open and smoke it. Now, this one I had never gotten before. This Jet Setter OG I have got. Okay, we're still here. Can anybody hear me yet? Can you hear me yet? Okay. Okay. Okay, we're back. Okay, we're back. Thank you. Whoever just said that, thank you, MNZ88. Thank you. Okay, guys, what happened is I got a phone call. I'm actually talking to Vora Motors. I got to call them back. Okay, so now I know when I get a phone call, the mic goes out. So I got to disconnect incoming calls. So for this one, I don't want to end the stream. We'll just keep going. I'll push through. We'll push through. We got 48 people in here. That's a lot of people. But okay, so the sound came back. Sound came back. Very good. What was I talking about? I was talking about nicotine. So this is the house brand. You know, when you go to a shop, sometimes they like grow their own nicotine, I guess. And like this is the house brand. So it's the name of the brand is Cream of the Crop. This is called Cream of the Crop OG. Now this I know is good. Sometimes the house brands are the best. Sometimes house brands can be really good. Just think about it. They don't have to go through a middleman to sell it. So you're just getting, you're potentially a better price, better deal. This shit was expensive. Oh God, it's so good. The appearance is so nice. It's a little dry. This shit's obviously been in here a while, but it's so good. And I think that's really, I got two of the Cream of the Crop OGs, two of the Jet Setters, and one of these runts. Although now I know next time I can, you know what it is you can't smell any of this before you buy it. You know, like you have to like take a chance. That's why I developed some, I can't believe I have brand loyalty with smoke, which was like unheard of, you know, back in the black market days. It's really no brands anyhow. You just have your dealer, I guess. But now since they don't, you know, before things got serious, you could walk into a shop, there'd be a big jar, and you could smell the jar. Go, oh, okay, give me some of that, and they weigh it out for you. But then to make it like a more legitimate business, because like you don't walk into a fucking store and they don't weigh your potato chips out for you, right? You know? And so like they made everything packaged. And they did a really good job. Like when you take the top off of this, it pops open, you know, boop, pop. So it's sealed. But I know some of these have been on the shelves for a long time. Now, I don't want to make this too much about the smoke. There's something wrong with my piece, by the way. There's always, like this particular piece, it always leaves smoke in it. Always got to do that. Because only a fucking animal smokes dirty smoke. Okay, so we're just going to hit this throughout the stream. I don't want to make the stream too much about this because I know you're not all into it, but deliveries are going good. I'm working, I've just basically committed my mind to working every day that it's not raining. Sometimes 3 hours, sometimes five or six, but I'm just making a ton of content. I'm actually accumulating a lot of videos because I'm not posting every day right now. I mean, just straight up talk between you and me. I know only my real fans kind of hear these videos. But since I'm not making a lot of affiliate sales right now, I'm not posting a tremendous amount of content. That might not make sense because you think, oh, the more content you post, the more you promote yourself. But the market is just slow right now. And it's not just me. I've talked to like every other YouTube channel this time of year, really November, December, January. Well, not November, December because of the holidays, but late December, January, February. These are not good months for affiliate sales because most of the country is cold. It's not really the economy or anything. I'm not making a political statement. But like the country is cold right now, you know, only certain parts of the country are you going to buy a brand new scooter and ride it. It's snowing in a lot of the country and it's freezing. California, we ride year round. So a lot of the sales that I have made this year in 2024 are to Californians. But since like volume of sales is low, I don't want to like put out tons of videos that are not going to get affiliate sales. So I'm quite a bit behind, guys. I'm probably 2 or maybe 3 weeks behind, like 15 or 20 full-length delivery videos behind. So what you're watching tomorrow, although sometimes I go, like I shot a video yesterday that I'm going to post tomorrow. The day after that, you're going to see a video that's from like 3 weeks ago and that'll move forward. I post out of sequence a lot. Each, I don't really have a theme in the videos. You know, each one is unique. That's why I don't do like, let's make $1,000 this week, blah, blah, blah. I always want the flexibility of posting out of time. There's lots of reasons for that. But anyhow, so I'm kind of banking all these episodes. So as business starts to get better, guys, we're going to have a video every fucking day. Like come like March, April, May, I'm going to like go for like 30 days straight, 50 days straight. I'm going to go crazy. And one way to do that is to get ahead on my videos. So I shoot videos. I just leave them on the HD card because I've learned not to download it on my, I don't have a computer. I edit on an iPad. was talking to Wilser, by the way. He was telling me he's going to help me get a good deal on buying a computer because I could make my videos a lot better if I had a better editing program. I don't really want to learn a better editing program. I love iMovie. I'm kind of addicted to it, to be honest with you. I'm so good at it. I've done so many episodes. Imagine this. I've done like 800 episodes on the iPad on iMovie. So learning a new editing program takes work. But anyhow, I'm just working every day. It's sunny. And I feel pretty good. Like I'm not burnt out. Like I'm not tired just being out there every day. If I need a day off, I'll take it. But when I take a day off, I'm like, I guess this is your life. I mean, I guess I'm a workaholic, not in the sense where I like put in a lot of volume of work. I don't work workaholism. You would think it'd be like, oh, you work 60, 50, 70 hours a week. For me, it's just working every day and the process of editing videos, a little bit of streaming and the, whatever the rest of my life is like, it's my life. So I don't mind it. You know, like I still love doing it. I'm tearing up here. I appreciate you guys. I mean, how do I was talking to the girl at Trader Joe's telling her about the channel. And I was like, yeah, I got lucky during COVID, I guess, a little bit, because it's like, how to, like, if you started, somebody asked me, I will get to your comments and questions. I'm letting them accumulate. Guys, 64 people in here. It's great. So I was talking to like the cashier at Trader Joe's, telling her, yeah, like I got lucky during COVID. I guess people were bored. They started watching delivery vlogs, you know, 2020. I've been doing it a long time. And she's like, and somebody asked me in the questions, like, what would you recommend somebody, like, what would you do if you're making a new delivery vlog and you want to post it on YouTube? I would say that if you're doing it for yourself, for your own gratification, which is why I started, just go ahead and do it and be prolific. Post as often as you can. Being prolific is the only hack there is for a new YouTuber. But I also said, if you want to get a lot of views, don't go into the delivery niche. It's an impossible fucking niche. I'm right there at like the bottom of the big delivery drivers. You know, there's me down here and there's London Eats up here. And the difference between these channels is gigantic in views. And there's nothing I could do to make a video that's so good that I'm going to get like another 100. Like I can't force a viral. I know that'll sound weird to probably anybody who doesn't do YouTube, but you have a better chance of making a viral video on a newer channel. Because once your channel is established and the algorithm, like my algorithm says, delivery videos, make anything other than a delivery video, we're not going to really promote it because it's had consistent success. And, you know, I make between like $500 and $900 a month from Google ads. So that means that advertisers are spending quite a bit of money on these fucking ads. Must be thousands of dollars. Point being is it's like I can't force the channel because I'm just naturally riding it. The only thing I've been doing recently is I've been doing shorts, and I'm only doing shorts to pump my subscribers up. Because my subscriber growth was so slow. And I think everybody who's been doing YouTube for a while now knows that shorts can blow up your subscriber count. I mean, look at Wilser's account. Wilser, I surpassed Wilser because I had a viral moment like a year and a half ago. Like he was at like 12 and I got above that because I had a 2 months going viral. Got all these 6,000 subscribers in 2 months. But then this was before shorts. And Wilser, he's so good at shorts. He's got good money from his shorts. He's got multi-million view shorts. Now listen, you want to make $100 on a YouTube short, you need 1 million views, okay? That's what I figured it out to be. So there's very little money in it. But Wilster's got a bunch of multi-million view shorts. And his subscriber count is now at like 40,000, you know? So it is a good way to pump up your subscriber count. But, and I've talked about this before, I don't want to have a big disparity between my subscriber count. Is the sound still good? I guess the sound is still good, right? I don't want to like have a big disparity between my subscriber count and my view count. Now, the advantage of having a high subscriber count is when, if you're selling yourself to other like affiliates, I don't do any of this really because I'm with Vora Motors and I work with them. All right, we're back. Hello. This is going to be the only stream. We're back, right? Hello. So I lost the visual for a second there. I'll know in the future to turn off my phone. I don't get a lot of phone calls, but I didn't know with the microphone. I should have known. Anyhow, I don't want to disconnect because we got a lot of viewers. We lost a bunch of them. I'll answer your questions. I'm coming. I'm just getting YouTube therapy from you guys right now. I'm just telling you about the experience with the channel. So I'm doing shorts to elevate my subscriber count. And within a month of doing shorts, I went from 250 subscribers gained a month to 500. So it works. And I've made some views on there with some like 10 and 20,000 view videos. But I mean, I've made $25 in revenue. There's no fucking revenue in shorts. Shorts are a little bit of a scam. It depends how you look at it. Like if you want to kind of semi, the point is when you inflate your subscribers through shorts, those are not viewer subscribers. It's very strange how YouTube set up this algorithm. I have no idea. But yeah, even if we lose the sound, the people who watch this, a lot more people will watch this after. So I appreciate those of you guys who didn't duck out. But people will come back. Oh, we're back to 67 people already. Am I seeing? I can't see my fucking. Oh, very good. So anyhow, so artificially inflating your subscriber count, I don't want to have a big disparity between number of views and subscribers. To me, that's not great. But if you're marketing yourself to like a company, most companies wouldn't know. They just say, oh, 18,000 subscribers, 20,000, 50,000. That is great. I don't think most people really, many like businesses really know how to analyze a YouTube channel. You could use Social Blade, but that is the most inaccurate thing I've ever seen in my life. So I'm gonna do these shorts for a little bit. I'm not gonna do them forever. I don't think they annoy any of my regular viewers, right? Because like, you probably watch most of my videos through recommended. That's how I watch YouTube. I mean, you can and you can also watch through your subscriptions, but whatever. You don't have to watch the shorts. The shorts are just from old videos. The shorts are never anything new. So, but anyhow, I've been doing TikTok too. Holy shit. Okay, so I don't know why I'm saying holy shit, because like TikTok has a billion fucking viewers, okay? So it's a lot easier for somebody to get views on there no matter what your niche is. Like I have friends who are like older Gen X and boomer friends who've been on Facebook making videos for years trying to get a YouTube channel. You know these channels that people post and they get 50 or 100 views, and I'm never making fun of anybody that does this. But once you have a channel like that for like 6 months that's not getting more than a couple hundred views in a video, it's not going to change. TikTok gives you a chance at least. TikTok gives you a chance to get views. Now, the problem is the views on TikTok are worth less than the short views because I'm not even monetized on TikTok. I don't even know what that takes. But my understanding is to make money on TikTok, you just do that through affiliates. But I've been posting on there like at least 3 times a day. And I got a couple of good hits. We're meeting a couple videos with above 100,000 videos. I know some of you guys mentioned it in the comments, but I posted that video of that guy with that other guy on the dog leash with the dog mask on. They were playing Pokemon today. And that video got 100,000 views on the overnight. Now, the thing is you TikTok views almost in no way translate over to YouTube. It's really unfortunate. It's really weird how... Because I've seen TikTokers try to start YouTubes with millions of TikTok fans. They cannot start a YouTube. I'm sure you guys have seen this. You see like a TikTok content creator that has millions of views, millions of subscribers, starts a fucking YouTube channel. They get 2,000 views. But that's so low for them, they never stick with it. So it's just like TikTok doesn't translate over to YouTube for subscribers and shit. Fucking sucks. Because like, think about it, there's a billion views. That means a lot of these are views of like probably like not even English speaking part of the world. Like just like it's very interesting to me. I don't even look at views. I look at comments. When you get a lot of comments on a TikTok video, maybe those people could be potential YouTubers. But I'll tell you, TikTok is rough. You don't want to post anything on it that like you got to be careful. Like I've been trolled on. The thing is, when you have a big video, you're going to get trolled no matter what. I learned that when I went semi-viral like a year and a half ago. I couldn't believe how much I was getting trolled, just generally trolled about different things. And that fucking sucked. Like I had to get used to it, and I had to learn like, oh, when you get a lot of viewers, you're going to get trolled. So DoorDash is good. Work is good. Scooter World is good. My InMotion RS front motor fucking died. I'm going to have a new one pretty soon, but that is very unfortunate. It is like kind of my favorite scooter to ride, the InMotion RS. I still recommend buying it because this hasn't been a problem we've seen on the groups, but something wrong with my front motor. So I'm already talking to Levin at Vora Motors. That's why he's calling me, I'm sure. And I'll have that shit replaced pretty quick. In Motion, I think, is pretty good with the way it works is, you know, Vora Motors is a dealer for In Motion, but if there's a warranty issue, like the parts come from In Motion. And when my rear shocks broke, they within 2 weeks, I had two, they gave me two rear shocks. There's only one for the rear. They sent me two of them. So we know that part has to be upgraded, but there doesn't seem to be a there does not seem to be a history of broken motors with the RS online so far. And it's been around for like a year now, I think, but mine broke, which is fucked up, guys, because I've never seen a motor in any of these scooters fail. I think actually the reason why it failed is the RS, the more you program and build for high performance, like super high performance, the more there's going to be a chance that something's going to go wrong with it. I guess see what my dogs are doing. They're all trying to like get into my dirty laundry. But don't fight. Ripley, get off of him. Get off. It's like, I got two pit bulls. You got to be careful. They'll fight. Lie down right there. Lie down. So, I don't know. Okay, so the RS is out of action for a little bit. I'm back on the GTR. I'm doing delivery shifts on the V2. I'm doing some short shifts on the Pro. I still obviously got a million fucking scooters here. But I really actually think that performance-wide and riding-wide, the RS is my favorite. Now, it doesn't mean it's for everybody. That shit is fucking dangerous. I had a couple of moments where I almost lost the handlebars. You know, it's a twist throttle. But it's a twist throttle. So, and it's angled towards you. And I don't think I think that it's not that grippy. So I've had a couple moments where it felt like, I almost let go. It's a combination of like the new position that I'm still getting used to. And I feel like the handles might be a little short. I mean, they fit my hands. But, you know, half of the right side is the throttle. So you're losing 25% of your overall grip, right? Something like that. I'm just making that shit up. So, what's up, Tyler Hunt? Okay, I just realized when you said, can you say Tyler, please? Of course, you're asking me to say your name. I'm down for it. Tyler Hunt, good to see you, buddy. I will get to the questions and shit in a minute. 71 people, why are we breaking? Oh, it's the weekend, that's why. It's like fucking, oh no, it's not the weekend. Fucking stoner. It's Monday. People aren't off because it's the day after the Super Bowl, right? I actually wonder if the algorithm recognizes that this stream is mic'd and it's promoting it more. Because to have 71 viewers is a lot for this fucking stream. We usually have 40 or 50. Anyhow. So, delivery is good. Scooter's good. We're back. 77 people. We're going to lose people because I got a phone call. I'm just not disconnecting the stream to turn off my calls. We're fine. We're back. That time it was like, I don't even know who the fuck it was that time. Guys, I want to get to your questions. We've been going for a while already, right? Why can't I fucking see how long we've been going for here? Well, half an hour already, right? It's hard to tell. 33 minutes. Okay, let me get to your questions and say hello to everybody while the sound is still good, right? And we're totally back, right? The sound is good. I'll grab a water. Guys, just tell me the sound is back. I'm just going to grab a water. Oh, fuck. I'm getting old. Hey, I wonder, can you guys hear me from the kitchen? How far away does this mic work? That is the question. Oh, my stomach hurts. I haven't eaten anything yet today. It's so easy for me to like, I guess that's why like, I feel like I'm not even that lean right now, but I'm not a fat person because I can easily go to like 230 without eating anything. My stomach is like acidic though. It fucking hurts. Wow, my teeth feel pretty good. I was worried they were going to hurt after that cleaning. 78 people. Okay. Let me say hello to everybody and answer questions as I go. Randall, first in. Good to see you, buddy. A regular supporter, LA sports fan, another regular. How you doing? Just got off work. I'm glad you made it. Rick Roberts, how you doing? See how many people react when you call them zombies on the street. You know what it's like? When you sit at a restaurant and you sit around tables of people, because my whole life people are telling me I'm too loud. I'm like, listen, you see that table next to you? You can't hear anything from them. Just think about that, because your brain or whatever. That's the same thing with the zombie thing. They're not looking for somebody to say anything, and there's all this ambient noise, and I am mic'd in the videos. So most people don't notice the zombie thing, the way majority. Rick Roberts. DeFang, D-F-E-V-A-N-G. Vang, what's up, buddy? Good to see you. Retro Shaver, dude. How you doing, man? I appreciate you watching the videos. 5150. My dog, Max, my pit bull, his owner got 5150 a bunch of times before she died. What's up, Mean Guru? I like that name. Mysterio 71, old school. Helga Rivers, I don't think I remember you, but I like that name. Very cool, Helga. We need, that's a woman's name, right? We need as many women as we can get. We're 97% male, according to the analytics. Andrew, just Andrew, good to see you. I like how you call me Yogi Bear, 5150. Hench Durance, it's a weird name, it's a good name. I kind of get it. Hench Durance, I've heard about you, I've met you before. Let's talk about the slave and the master. I thought that only happens in London. No, this is Hollywood. You know, that video went viral so fucking quick on TikTok. I was thinking like, well, if I was to make another channel, I should just go down to Hollywood Boulevard and just video the weird shit. But I think like a lot of people already do that. And like moments like that, that's very unique. Seeing somebody with the full fucking dog mask on and the leash. I didn't know they were playing Pokemon, because you can barely hear what they're saying in the video. But I guess if you know what you're looking for, you can hear that they're, thank you, What Traffic, for the $4.99. For you, What Traffic, I'm going to break open a new container. You watch this video. If you just got here, I show these at the beginning. We're burning quality nicotine. Thank you for the $4.99 super chat. God, you distracted me though. What the fuck was I talking about? The slave and the master. So that video on TikTok was interesting. TikTok, I can tell, is like already. It's like it's no different than YouTube, where once you're on there and you've posted a bunch of videos, you got a little bit of momentum. Put the ashes right on the floor. This is fucking old school, gross. Like I know how my videos perform on TikTok already, so it's like I put a video. If it doesn't get 600 views in the first like half hour, it's gonna do bad. If it gets 600 to 1,000 views in the first half hour, that means it's probably going to get 5,000 views, which is great. But it's like anything else. So when I posted that video went truly viral on its own. Because when I posted that video, we're talking about the slave and the master dog video, which is on YouTube, which, you know, a guy walking there with another guy on a leash, basically. You can hear what they're saying, and they're playing Pokemon, which I couldn't really hear what they were saying at all. But I guess if you know the lingo of Pokemon, they're playing Pokemon. So I posted that. I only noticed it was they were playing Pokemon because somebody in the comments said something. That video didn't do good in the first half hour or hour. It got like 300 views. I was shocked. I was like, oh, I thought this would be a good video. But then I don't know what happened. I think it's people on there, when they comment, it really makes a difference. So people started commenting on the video. A couple people especially saying, oh, this is they're playing Pokemon. And the video like took off like hours after a video would normally take off, and now it's like a rocket ship. It's got like 100,000 views in a day. It's worth almost exactly zero to me. You know, it's like I don't get affiliate links from that, affiliate clicks. You know, I have like the link tree tells me where my clicks come from, and they're not coming from TikTok. So, but it's a start. It's a start. I would like to get monetized. The sound is still good, guys. All right, we're looking good. All right, Peter, I'm going to let through all these emojis one time. They're asking me. So, yeah, I want to make money on another platform, you know, like just being on fucking YouTube is great. But I think I know how to do it. Like, I think like TikTok, I already kind of have it figured out. Post, be prolific, post a lot. And as boring as a single delivery video of one delivery from beginning to end might be for a YouTube fan, it does really good on fucking TikTok. And I've got two videos on there with 500,000 views, and they're just a single delivery. So I wanna get good on TikTok. So that slave and master video, we'll see how. You guys want to know how it's doing on YouTube right now? YouTube Shorts they also grow in a very specific way. YouTube Shorts, I post them, they get like no views or very few views for the first couple hours, and then all of a sudden, 3,000 views like in the first couple hours. So this video has only got 68 views so far, but it's still fresh. I'll get at least 2,000 views on almost any video in a short. It's worth literally nothing. It's worth not even, I think it's worth 20 cents actually. Is it worth 20 cents or 2 cents? It's worth almost nothing. So anyhow, get back to here. Let me get to the next person in question. I got a little distracted about the slave and master video. That's a tough name. What's up, CMP LX Design, Complex Design? I got it. Salute to you. James Otgen, one of the oldest of the old school. How you doing, friend? It's good to see you. Colorado Adventure Channel. This guy knows his stuff. Good tight edibles are badass. Yeah, you got to do your teeth, bro. Do it now. I waited too long. 143 Ganja. Let me hit this puff puff for what traffic? Who basically paid for it. Fuck. It's just nicotine, by the way. Hello? Wow, did I hang up fast enough this time or we didn't lose the sound? That we didn't lose the sound. Next time, I'm faded a little bit. I just want to make sure the sound is still here. Next time I stream, I'll turn off the phone. It's a mistake to disconnect a live stream for any reason. So you guys have sound now. Is the sound back? I want to make sure the sound is back before I start telling you guys. I want to respond. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Z Marshall. Z Marshall, my local friend. Good to see you, buddy. We'll have another group ride again soon. 143 Ganja, Bubble Magic, old school. Let's see here. Rick Roberts, when I do the math, you said your last rent is $2,000 or your daughter's rent? Yeah, no, I'm a personal trainer. I make affiliate sales. I make money from ads, and I do DoorDash. So I basically have four jobs. Ice Gorilla Gum, that sounds good, Colorado. Oh, you're my friend Chris, right? Why do I not remember your fucking guys? I'm sorry if I can never put like Facebook and YouTube together. Colorado Adventure Channel. Is that Chris? All right, Creasonator, another old school follower. Good to see you. Caster 50. So hello, what's up, Caster 50? Chad Beeve, RTP Vibes, Apricot Mango. You guys are just like basically telling me at this point the sound is bad. This is way back in the stream. I like to say hello to everybody. It's Leo. Good to see you, another regular. DiCaprio Amor. Castro 50, how much to bleed your brakes? $50. $50. You got to bring it to me. Tyler Pinkerton, how you doing? Package Man. How do you guys get these names? Especially OG Duvinson Jackson. What's up with you? We're smoking a Runts. We're smoking two different types of OGs. Watch this video from the beginning. I talk more about it. What's up, Carlos? Good to see you, buddy. You might be late, but we're going for a while. BSAW 22, MNZ 88, how you doing? Misty Duncan, how are you? You swallowed shampoo. What should I do? That's funny. I have no idea. RTP Vibes, I'm planning to build a record-breaking scooter because why not? If it's successful, would you like to give it a try? It would top out around 9,200 with an estimated range of 100 miles per hour. Listen, I will ride it for a video, but I'm not going faster than like 60. Seriously, like I feel like 60 is about the fat because I've done like 55, you know, I haven't really done 60. And would I ride a homemade scooter? Yes, you bring it to me and make a great video. You know where I live, Hollywood, California. Tamsy, how you doing? Good to meet you. You're new. Good. Thank you very much. What's up, Tamsy? MNZ 88. I think I said hello to you. I'm not sure. Did I ever grease the bearings on the GT Pro for the steering? No, I don't grease. I don't grease anything. I use like bead sealant. I use hydraulic oil, but I've never greased anything. That's weird. You would think that I would, right? Tommy Ososki. I should know this name. This should be an easy name for me. OSS Ososki. Why not? Ososki. Yeah, it's an easy name. What's up, buddy? He said the Super Bowl sucks. I didn't even watch it. Alexander 2. How you doing, buddy? Has a GTR. How do I increase the range on the GTR? Do I ride on dual motors? Okay. To get the most range out of the scooter, ride it in the slowest gear you can ride it in and still feel like it's fast enough. I ride the GT and the GTR in second mode. I mean, I put it into third if I want to go a little faster, but 35 miles an hour is basically fast enough. And there's nothing you can do to extend your range on any scooter except add battery to it. I always ride dual motors. I never see any reason to not. The only time I ever ride in a single motor, okay, is if I'm limping home. That means I'm very, very low on battery. I will put it on a single motor, lowest gear, and limp home, I call it. You know, limping home, going slow so I can make the battery last longer. But always dual motor. It makes no sense to me to have a motor in each wheel and not have them working. Like, I know there's been a lot of tests done, a lot of great scooter people have already done the test, and they're like, it's not that much of a difference in energy between one and two motors. Because it's easy to think that if you don't have a motor going, aren't you dragging the other motor kind of, even though it's spinning? You know, there's weight there and shit, but I just don't see any reason to ride single motor, a dual motor scooter and single motor unless I'm limping home. So, and I don't think single motor saves that much battery. Going slower saves battery. That's the answer. Accelerating slower saves battery. What's up, Rebvir, R-E-B-V-R? Just Rumi, good to see you, friend. Take a banana for the... I wish I had a banana. I have melon. Just Rumi, recommending a banana for my acid stomach. I have cantaloupe. It'll be perfect. Vin Russo, PayPal, yoga dude here. Yeah, Vin, don't drop me another $50 super chat. I mean, Vin Russo is crazy generous with me. Okay, I just gave you my email. My email is in the chat, Vin Russo. If you get it now, fine. If you're not there anymore, fine. That's fine. Ooh, I'm getting a very interesting Facebook message from my friend Alfonso. I don't think he'll mind me saying this. He says, okay, it's time to talk seriously about the Roadster. This guy's got a Nami. He's got a Mantis King GT. Like, that's his smaller scooter. He's got a Nami as his bigger scooter. My friend Alfonso is a cool guy. I told him, I said, look, I'm going to go to Vora Motors to try the Roadster. There's not enough Roadsters on the market for them to be fucking giving these scooters out. They've given me a tremendous amount of scooters this last year, and there's no reason to think they're going to give me a Roadster. But I would imagine, like, I mean, when the Storm came out, I'm sure I would have said they would never would have given me a Storm, and they gave me a Storm. But I think that you got to wait for a model to be out for a long time for any company to kind of give it to an affiliate, especially at my level. I mean, I did sell a lot of scooters to them last year. But I just feel like, you know, I might not get a Roadster, at least not soon. But we can go to Vora Motors together and test ride it. And I can bring, I already asked Melvin, can I bring some people with me? This is my friend Alfonso, who is serious. You know, I don't really know much about his, like, financial background or anything. Like, meaning that, like, you're serious if I think you have money. But he already has a Nami. He's got a King GT. He actually has a very cool car that is decked out in Star Wars stuff. So I got a feeling he could probably afford whatever, this fucking Roadster. They're like $6,000 plus, right? So, like, that's what it means to me when somebody is a serious customer or not. Like, if I know you too well and I know you don't have any money, like, I only want to bring potential customers with me, because I'm not going to get a commission on this, just so you know. I'm pretty sure there's no commission for me to sell a Roadster. But if somebody's interested in riding one and they're local and you want to go to Vora Motors with me and be in my video, let's fucking do that. So I just got, it's funny, I need to go to Vora to ride this vehicle. I've just been lazy about it. And again, whatever, you guys who really know me, my friend Sarah's out of town. She's been out of town for like a month, and she's the person who would drive me anywhere. I might rent a car. By the way, also thinking about renting a Corvette to do deliveries in. I can rent a Corvette for $500 2 days. Should I rent a Corvette for $500 to do deliveries in? I realized on Turo, there's at least one guy who will rent you a fucking Corvette. Like, I think that'd be dangerous. Like, I've never driven, like, a real small sports car like that, or, like, that type of sports car. They're not even that small. Anyhow, I want to say hello to everybody. Z Marshall, it's good to see you when you came in. They might, who knows what they range test in. They use fucking midgets for range testing. Rick, the cops do not bother me out here anymore. They used to, for sure. But I actually make it a point to look over my shoulder. You know, I look over my fucking shoulder before I do anything crazy. I think I'm caught up. Just King 27, how you doing? He's like, what's this? I don't know. It is what it is. Three Popular Games Gang. Oh, that's the name. That's your name. Three Popular Games. Yeah, there you go. Three Popular Games Gang. Good to meet you, buddy. There's your shout out. Never met you before. Yeah, Z Marshall. Now, listen, whether or not, I don't know enough about you to know you, if you could afford a, whether or not you can afford a roadster, doesn't matter in this case. That's what we're talking about. If you're going to drive me there, pick my ass up, boom. I know how to contact you online, buddy. I will hold you to that, okay? That's okay. It's okay. It's okay, Nicole. Like, he hasn't spammed. The Three Popular Games gang has not spammed yet. It's only been, like, three messages is okay. It's acceptable. But if anybody spams on here, Nicole, they're gone. Believe me. I'm the moderator on here. I'll get them out of here. It's pretty easy to do. So, oh, they're like $8,000. I don't know how much the roadsters are. I'm not even paying attention to it. I'm not sure if it's all carbon fiber, MNZ88, but it's a lot of carbon fiber. It looks cool. I mean, I'm not a speedster. I've said this over and over and over again. Like, I'm not into scooters for the speed. I occasionally show speed in the videos because I know people want to see that. But, like, I'm not going to go 80 on the fucking roadster. I'm probably just going to ride it in their parking lot. But, yeah, Z Marshall, I will hit you up for a ride if it comes down to that. I was thinking about renting a car to go there. We'll see. I like Turo. I've been using Turo. But, well, thank you, Mr. Tahoe. Mr. Tahoe, well, Jen Bartel sends cute dog, and Mr. Tahoe says your dog is a whole vibe. Yeah, you know, like, this is a real lap dog. I love him. I have two pit bulls, and if you have dogs, you know anything about dogs, like, there really is such a thing about dog personality. And when whoever, it probably didn't take long for the first person that had a dog like this to create the phrase lap dog. Because this fucking dog just wants to be in your lap. This dog brings me like so much stress relief and relaxation. And, you know, I actually, before him, I lived with a woman. Like, I got this dog when I broke up with a girlfriend. Like, God, are you this fucking old, dude? I think I broke up with this girl 10 years ago. My God, are you 10 fucking years old, dude? I don't know how old this guy was. He acts pretty young still. But, he sleeps with me. Like, so I have pit bulls, and my whole life having, I had one pit bull, then two. I don't let my pit bulls like sleep with me. When your dog is young, you know, it wants to sleep in your bed. And pit bulls, like having a guardian breed like this, I just never let my pit bulls sleep with me. They can sleep on the floor. They can sleep on the couch. They can walk into their open crate, but I don't let my, never for years let my pit bulls sleep with me. But this guy sleeps with me. You know, it's like the bond between like a small breed lapdog like this and the owner, it's very intense. I'm going to cry thinking about him. I mean, he's got problems though. This dog's got epilepsy. He's had seizures and shit. I was giving him CBD, but now his seizures are a lot less intense, but he's a total fucking vibe. He is fucking awesome. Saturn says the Chihuahua is terrifying. He can be tough. He stands up for him. He lives with two pit bulls. Think about it. He lives with two pits, both of them who are fucking warriors. Would I try faster than 55 with more gear? Not really, Creationator. Okay. Rick Roberts says, if a cop tries to pull you over, are you running or pulling over? No, I got to get the content. Running won't be content. Running could be content, but you're just going to give yourself away. But no, I got to pull over, get the content. I love getting pulled over. I'm looking to get pulled over at this point. It's been such a long time. My pull, like, I really feel like I've been doing this. So it's weird how I don't think doing something for 5 years is that long. I'm like from this old school mentality where it takes 30 years to get great at something, or at least 10. But it's weird. I've been doing this for 5 years. It feels like a lifetime. My early pulled over videos are fucking epic. That one video where I'm face to face with the cop, like berating me, and I'm being super nice to him, super cool. Like, that video is fucking. Let's watch that video right now. Let's watch this fucking video together real quick. I wish I could put it up on the screen. The Electric Scooter Academy pulled over. This shit will just come right up because I made a short. Oh no, what did I fucking do? What the fuck?
When you turned your head?
I'm always looking over my left. I saw a motorcycle.
Did I didn't know he was there. When you looked over your shoulder?
I didn't know it was a motorcycle, police officer, but I saw a motorcycle. Yes, sir. Okay.
So you can't ride this on fountain to begin with at all. There's no painted, dedicated bicycle lane. Those are charros. Those aren't bicycle lanes.
You guys hear this?
You can't even be on that road.
Okay, yes, sir.
You have something good going for you. You have a helmet.
Yes, sir.
Okay, you can't jump ahead of traffic making a left turn there. You didn't go through the red signal because I probably would have cited you for that. That's $492.
Yes, sir.
I understand you're delivering food. You do it in a jiffy and stuff.
In a jiffy.
I'll remember you for that.
Yes, sir. No, I'm the only guy doing this.
Fountain going to 25-mile-an-hour streets. Santa Monica, you can ride from Kings Road to Doheny. It's a dedicated painted bicycle lane. You can be on that.
Yes, sir.
Otherwise, 25-mile-an-hour streets.
You guys can watch that on your own. But that video is fucking epic. Okay, that video is 3 years old. What's the date on this? What's the video? It's just, why is this? Oh, okay, April 2020. April. It's almost 4 years old. I've been doing this a long fucking time. But anyhow, that video is fucking epic. You're asking me about being pulled over. Like, I would never run. I want to get more footage like that. You know, there is the worry that they'll impound you. You know, that's the thing. Like, I don't want my fucking scooter impounded. You know, like, that would be the fucking nightmare.
But anyhow, that video.
Yeah. Yeah, I should go back, see Marshall. Like, I never republish old videos, but I should. I should, like, I'd have to copy it off of YouTube. I don't have the original footage. 44 Unda says, you should deliver for dinner instead of lunch. I agree, there's more money for dinner. But it's just more dangerous at night. And I don't know, like, I'm a very committed person. Like, when I commit to, like, something, I've kind of committed to not working at night. Because the first couple of years when I did work at night, it was, look who's back. His name is Bishop, by the way. Not a religious Bishop. Bishop from the movie Aliens. And my other pitbull's name is Ripley, also from Aliens. What was I fucking saying? Oh, I don't even ride at night. Like, I did a couple of years of hardcore nighttime riding. You should go back and watch my old videos if you want to see nighttime. I worked, you know, full shifts, especially during COVID. COVID was weird, man. I don't even think about it, like how I transitioned. I had 15 full-time clients coming to my apartment for 7 or 8 years as, like, my whole life, my business. And I lost, like, all but five. I still have five of them. And one of them I do online exclusively, which is great. But it's funny to think about that. That's why I started doing deliveries. I didn't start doing deliveries. No, I started doing deliveries because I was a personal trainer. I was making great money. But it's hard making more money because it's hard getting new students. So first I started doing deliveries. And then YouTube hit. Then, like, the COVID hit. And that pumped up YouTube for me. That's the way I look at it. You got pulled over on your Roadrunner Pro Frontier? Well, this thing looks like a fucking motorcycle, right? What's up, Danny Burley? Yeah, motorcycle cop will fucking pull you. I learned back then that cops in SUVs and cars, they're not going to pull you over for the most part. But motorcycle cops, my buddy Joe, okay? That's his real name. It's very generic. I'm not giving anything away. He's a retired Seattle police officer. He retired, like, right at the best time, like 5 years ago, okay? Like, right before, I think, becoming a cop probably became a harder job. He's like, yeah, motorcycle cops, a lot of those guys, they did not sign up. You don't sign up to be a cop to get fucking traffic tickets. So he's like, a lot of these fucking motorcycle cops are dicks. And, you know, I'm totally pro-police, a big supporter of the police, whatever way. But, you know, it's like motorcycle cops are the ones gunning for you. So I learned that a long time. Anyhow, pretty sure the sound is probably back. I know we lost it for a second. Yeah, Rick, you can't be selling shit on here. Like, if you have friends with somebody, like, don't offer stuff for sale on here, okay, Rick? All right, guys. I actually do think I forgot. I have something. That's what that call was. I do have to go. I actually have to go sooner rather than later. I have to go in like 2 minutes. Okay, so guys, I do have to go. I'm sorry. I forgot that I have this fucking thing to do. It's not like I'm in the fucking mob, right? But I do have this thing. So I'll stream again. Thanks for fucking joining me. I don't really got that much else to say anyhow. I don't have a list today, but I appreciate everybody's support. Bishop was happy to meet you. We got a good chance to talk about him. And I'll stream again. Normally I like to end. What's up, Z? Thanks, Z. Normally, I like to end, like, on my terms, you know, give you a heads up, like, more of a heads up. but I have to do this thing. I promised that I would do this thing with this guy. For real. We can do a hit, though. Sorry, Monkey. Alrighty, guys. Thank you. Oh, thank you, K-Dog. I appreciate the sub. Thank you very much. It goes a long way. Alrighty, guys. I'll see you next time.